So I was in Starbucks of MTSU. I was by myself, and I have like a little notepad and everything in my backpack. And all of a sudden, like, this chorus just kind of like hit me. And it was like, pack up your suitcase, dear, you know? And it had like this boom, 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 boom. And so it was like kind of like, had this like weird rhythm where it was kind of like off a little bit. And it was actually a really happy song. I don't know if I ever told you about that.
I didn't know, so that was a happy one.
Yeah, it was happy. It was a pack up your suitcase, dear. Well, I'll go back to the verse. I wrote part of the first verse alone. It was same jeans I wore yesterday, same clothes, but on a different way. And, same problems, just give them different names. I didn't have the same band line. I don't know. I think I just had the two first lines, actually. And then I wrote the chorus, and it was, pack up your suitcase, dear. I'm just trying to go before the sun goes down. All I'm trying to do is pick you up before I leave this town. Before I leave this town.
Oh, man, that's totally different.
Yeah. Before I leave this town. And, like, it was just so happy. Like, it was basically, the message was, like, same old, everything's kind of getting boring in this town. Like, I just want to pick you up and leave this town before the sun goes down. Mm-hmm. Like, I just want to get out of here. Let's go. And I saw Austin and Sebastian that night. And we were just hanging out. We just wanted to jam after something. I think it was after one of the open mic nights they had. And we just wanted to jam because, like, we just wanted to play. That's what we always wanted to do. And we went in the stairwell, and we were jamming, singing different songs, and I was like, I've got the song I wrote today, can we finish it? Like, I'd love to, like, you know, so I sang it for them, and they were just like, oh, man, I love that. You know, so we started writing the first verse, and I think Austin said the line, the same problem, was just giving different names, and I was like, oh, my God. I was like, oh my, that's so heavy. Like, that's such a good line. Like, I was like, geez. So we started writing that chorus, and we went into it, and we're like, this, I don't know, this isn't enough anymore. Because, like, that line just kind of hit it, and it was like, oh, gosh, like, there needs to be something more powerful in the chorus. So we were just singing it, I was playing those chords, and Austin came up with the line, one more day of going through the motions is gonna pull me to the ground. Austin was actually the one who came up with that.
So he's the one who turned it from like a happy runaway lover song to like the ultimate breakup song.
Yes, and yes, and I was like, are you okay? Like, what the heck, man? And I mean, this is the reason why I say, like, I think it was all divided up even between us, because it's not putting the ground without, you know what I mean? Like, I would have never thought of that line, because I had a mindset of like, holding hands, driving away in a sunset. You know what I mean? And like, that's just so like immature compared to like what it is now. Mm-hmm. And so we had that, and then we went into like, okay, so now they're like, they're together, but like they're not happy anymore. So like, that's the story that we're going by. And so then I came up with like St. Paul's, just I feel like home. You know, same words, just in a different tone. Like all these things. And I can't remember who came up with each specific line in the second verse, but I remember there was this hole in the third verse, and we couldn't think of a line, and we were just like going crazy, because like, we were just like, I don't know what we should put there, we'll go back to it. So we're singing like the chorus and everything, and then all of a sudden, this is, like, literally out of nowhere, Austin thinks of the bridge, just like there, like, he's like, I've got something. I was like, what's up? And he just said the line. He's like, close the door, leave the keys on the island. It's not my fault you didn't know about that. And I was like, what? It's like, what is that? Like, what should that be? Because we were actually like trying to think of like that line in the verse, but I was like, that doesn't make sense for the verse. Like, let's think of something different. But then I was like, that needs to be in the song. I was like, that's so good. I was like, gosh, so we started writing, like, we started singing, and then we were like, that needs to be the bridge. So we, like, we get to the bridge, and he sings it, like, low and everything, and literally, it just happened so organically. Like, the way that we recorded it is the same way that we, like, were sitting there in that room, and just kind of pull up the guitar and show, like, I mean, like, it's over here, but,
hold on a second. I don't know if that's a good out, but,
anyway, so, like, we're sitting there, and I just kind of was going back and forth. So he's just like, starts singing, he's like, close the door, leave the keys on the eye. So you're just kind of like moaning out, it's not my fault, didn't know what you buy. So we were just like going, and then I just kept building the guitar. I mean, I just couldn't stop it. It's like, this is a big room like this. So like, the louder you get, the better it sounds, you know? So you're like, they just weren't good enough. It was in the second verse. And finally, after just like sitting there forever, we came up with the same bed, but with a wall between our bones. Same girl, but I'm better on my own. And we left, like that was the last thing we did. And then we just like packed up the guitar and we were like, okay, we're done. And then I was walking back with Sebastian and we were just like completely quiet. We weren't like saying anything. Like just walking back to the car. And like, there wasn't anything like super like, yes, we just wrote this song, like, yeah, it feels so good. It was just like a song and we finished it and we were like, okay, we're done writing that one. Like, thank God, that was so hard. but then we started playing it for people and like it got a better response than anything any of us had like ever written. And like, then we ended up singing that song, you know, the amp. Or the CMA songwriting thing. Did I tell you we weren't going to sing that song that night?
Yeah, it was a different one the day before, wasn't it?
Yes.
Like on the video.
The morning of was different. Yeah, Touch the Ground was the song that we were going to sing. And that song was, it's like, show me how to feel, I am dying, show me what it takes. So it's like very happy. Mm-hmm. And Jake texted me that morning of the show, and I was like, y'all have to do for me to grow. It's like, I need y'all to do for me to grow. Like, that's just been on my mind. And I was like, okay. So I called up Sebastian and I was like, can you sing with me, you know, tonight at the show? And Austin was going to sing too, but he couldn't make it. And he had some fraternity thing or something. But so Sebastian came up there and sang it with me. And it was a great time. People accepted it well and, you know, kept pushing it from there. But anyway, that's the story that was written.
No. That's just the story before I was there. So then where'd you play it after you played at the CMA thing? Where's the next place you took it?
The next place I took it, man, I'm trying to think. I don't know. Had we decided? I can't remember if we decided to record it or not at that time. I can remember what we did before then. Before that show, we were at Jake's house. And we were just like bouncing off songs. Everybody was sitting around the fire just like sharing songs. And I was like, oh, me and Sebastian just like wrote this song the other day. And they're like, oh, well, let's hear it. So like we just pulled it out and we sang it. And that's when I met Moose that night. And Moose came up to me and he's like, we're freaking cutting that song, man. Like, we're gonna record that. I was like, this guy, like, no way. Like, this guy's just like, one. Like, I don't know. And plus, I was like, I don't know about this guy. Like, I just met him and he's. Goes by Moose. Yeah. It's kind of strange. You know, I was like, I don't know.
Did he ever tell you how he got that name?
Yeah, it's because his dad, like.
It's because he's clumsy.
Yeah.
And his dad was making fun of him.
Yeah. Yeah, it's so strange. When I met him, he's like, hey, my name's John, but like, you can call me Moose. I was like, cool, my name's Daniel, you can call me Gazelle. He's just like, fucking smart ass. You know, so we like started talking. And I just clicked him in so well. I mean, he's such a cool guy, you know. But yeah, I don't know where we took it right after, if I'm being completely honest.
I think the next time I saw it would have been after the CMA thing. I guess it would have been Indie Woods.
Wow, okay.
And then, because I left town, I went back to Knoxville. And
wow.
And I came back for Indie Woods.
Yeah.
And then I saw it again at Sierra's house.
Yeah.
And I've seen every version of it at Moose when he's been recording it. I've been listening to it sometimes.
Yeah.
I've seen the whole process. This is my baby.
This is your baby, exactly. Yeah. I mean, like, it's just kind of like, I play that song so many times, you know? And, like, you get to a point where it's like, okay, all right, I'll play it again. But, like, at the same time, every single time I play it, I get lost in the song, and I love it. Like, but it drains me.
Yeah.
Every time. But I love it. I love, like, the fact that it drains me, and I get emotionally, like, into it. But I actually ended up singing it on MPSC's radio one time with Moose and Dusty.
Oh, yeah, I was out of town, and you did the video for that one.
Yeah.
Great video, crisp.
Thank you so much, man. I really didn't know what I was doing. I was just like...
You don't need to. You just have to hold the camera.
Yeah. That's also another thing. I'm sure you've experienced this, but I love, like, being able to have something to give to somebody like that. Like, because it doesn't take much for me to show up and just, like, record that. Yeah. I mean, that was just me just, like, being there and, like, aiming the camera at people when they're talking and, like, you know, when their hands were moving a certain way, like, capturing that. Like, there's nothing, like, special about, like, the way I did that. It was just, like, the fact that I had something to give to them, you know, felt, like, so good. And, like, to see their faces whenever they, like, saw the footage and the photos, they would, like, it's just, like, very rewarding.
That's what it's all about.
Yeah. I really genuinely love, like, being able to give that to people, you know? And it's the same thing with music. Like, it literally, it's the same concept. Like, because right now, I mean, with both of us, like, we're not really, like, having real income from what we love to do.
Yeah.
But the only income we have is, like, people's reactions and, like, what people get from the songs you give them.
It's true.
And, you know, songs isn't photos for you, you know, and it's just like, it's so nice to be able to show somebody and then be like, oh my gosh, I love that. You know what I mean? It's like, you're almost like giving somebody something for like 3 minutes, you know what I mean? And it's just like, I love playing the music, but I also like, as much as I love playing the music, I love the way people receive music. And it's just, I don't know. That's why I feel like I'm still driven to like keep pushing, even though I'm not getting any money from it,
yeah.
And even though it's not a career yet. You know what I mean? So.
So what specific field of music do you want to go into? Do you want to be like a songwriter or a performer?
I love performing. Like, if it comes down to it, I'll be a songwriter if I do well there. You know what I mean? That's another one of those things where it's like you have to be successful to like do that. But my biggest dream would be to be a performing artist. Because like I was just telling you, I love like people's reactions and the way people react to music. Mm-hmm. And like to be able to like deliver that to people and like see that on their faces and like give them a show. Like, I love that. And I mean, I just absolutely love performing. Like, there's this high that you get from it that you cannot get anywhere else.
It's true.
And I mean, it's just like, it's addicting. And like, people are always like, oh, it's so hard to like go on tour, like you'd be exhausted all the time. It's like, yeah, but like you'd be exhausted because you're doing what you love to do. Like, you know, it's a good exhaustion. You know what I mean? And I'm like, I would love to do that. You know what I mean? I'd love to be exhausted.
Well, I think when you shoot this music video, you're gonna find that it's not so fun to play your song like 20 times in a row with no audience there.
Yeah.
I think I don't know how you're gonna feel about music videos. They're not very fun to do.
Well,
it's all about the end product, I guess.
It is, yeah. I mean, it's the same thing with recording, though. I mean, we had to take so many takes of, I mean, there's no telling how many times we sang this song just from doing that. Are you good, man? It's the same thing with, like, recording the song, because, like, we're playing it over and over again, and, like, singing it over and over again, and, like, fixing things over and over again, and, like, Moose is hearing it time and time again. There's no telling how many times he's heard that song.
Like, can't even imagine.
In the thousands. Like, thousands with an S. Like, I don't even know. I mean, it's insane. But I don't know, man. It will be interesting because it will be, like, a performance where I'm having to, like, protect myself and, like, really perform, you know. But I don't know. I'm actually kind of looking forward to seeing how that goes.
I think it's going to be interesting to see the difference between performing and pretending like you're performing.
Yeah.
Because there's the other music videos I've done, there's like a big difference.
Yeah.
And it shows, and it's, I mean, you gotta sell it up. Otherwise it'll look weird on camera.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. Either way, I feel like it will be a real performance, and I'm gonna do my best.
It'll be fun.
A real performance. But it's gonna be neat to do that. It's gonna be really neat. I don't know, just like, every time like I play the song, even when I'm like practicing the song with people, like I literally do it exactly how I'm doing it in front of, you know, 50 to 100 people. And like, I would not like to change it any other time when I'm doing it. Because I can't imagine like singing that chorus that last time and just kind of being like, pack up your suitcase, dear, I'm just trying to go, okay. When's the song gonna be over? You know, like, okay. You know, but like, I just want to like give that to people, even if there's nobody in the room. You know what I mean? Like, because that's what the song deserves. You know what I mean? And at that point, it's just for the song. You know. But
I think one thing that's interesting, from my perspective at least, is everyone talks about how authentic this song is for you, even though you didn't write all of it. You wrote a happy song, and then someone else came in and made it sad, but you just put it all out there for the performance, and people buy it.
Exactly.
That's interesting.
People really, because you become a character like for every song you sing, and that's something I've talked to Bailey about, the girl I'm talking to. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that in the camera.
You can say anything you want, but I don't know.
Yeah. Some people just don't understand that you're turning into a character, because a lot of times, like a song that was really true for me when I wrote it isn't true for me anymore. But every time I sing that, I'm back in that moment. Mm-hmm. I am that character. Like, I am that person who's dealing with that. So it's draining, because there's like, I don't know if I played Judy for you yet.
Yeah, I heard that at Sierra's house as well.
Okay, that song is not true for me at all. I mean, like, there is like a hint of like depth for me in that song, but the story, like the story and the verses aren't like, I know I came here that stormy night, but we both know it wasn't right. I didn't go to any girl like on some stormy night. Like, but in that moment, it's true for me. You know what I mean? Like, and that's why I feel like people think it's authentic, because it is authentic for me in that moment, because that is actually the emotions I'm going through when I become that character when I'm singing that song. Like, by the end of the song, I want Judy so bad, like, to just, like, understand what I'm trying to say. Like, in that moment, I'm in love with Judy, but I don't need to be with her, and I'm telling her that. So that's why it's literally just so raw, because that is who I am in that moment. And it's just, like, a lot of people that don't perform don't get that. And, like, I've talked to people before, and they've just been like, that doesn't make any sense.
It's the same with, like, screenwriting. Like, you have to become those characters to write those.
Yeah, I don't know how people do that.
I had to stop doing it, because I'd get depressed from, like, writing characters and being in that headspace for, like, hours.
Yeah.
I had to stop doing it.
Yeah. But Put Me in the Ground, every time I sing that, I'm telling this girl to pack up. I don't know who the girl is, but I'm telling her to pack it up. And I'm doing my best to let her know that it was not my fault. Like, I'm literally, like, so into it as, like, that person that I'm not even thinking about who I actually am at all. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, I'm not in a, like, broken relationship. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not in a, like, the halls feel like home. They don't, you know, like, there's nothing, like, weird. And so for me to sing that, it is weird to me that people say it's authentic, because that song never really has been true for me. You know what I mean? But in that moment when I'm performing it, it is, 100%. So, but that's how all my songs are. The majority of them, I'm that person in the song, like, when I'm singing it.
So how hard would it be to go from, like, Put Me in the Ground to maybe one of your happy songs, back-to-back platinum?
It wouldn't be hard at all. I mean,
just switch it like that?
I think that's actually a really interesting question. I haven't done that in a while, because a lot of times Put Me in the Ground is the last one I sing in a set, just because it's such a heavy song.
Yeah.
And it would be awkward for listeners to go from hearing, "It's not my fault you didn't know what confinement," to me being like, "Everything's gonna be okay." You know what I mean? Like, so it's just like this thing where, like, I haven't put myself in that situation yet, but if I had to, it'd be really difficult. But I would do it, because that's what would the song would call for. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And because I do have like a lot of happy songs. I feel like that's a lot of times what my mind resorts to, is like, I have a negative message, and then there's some kind of twist where I make it, like, positive. But that's why I write with other people, because they can, like, bring out different parts of that in me, and they can, like, put in what they have. Because a lot of, like, Austin, a lot of his songs are the opposite. They're, like, it can be, like, positive, but have, like, negative connotations. And, like, he's literally got a song called "A Woman I Can Use."
Oh, God.
Like, literally, like, heavy stuff. Like, and, there's just, like, a lot of his songs are just, like, very, like, brutal and, like, honest. And that song might even be more true for him than it is for me, because he wrote that bridge, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But at the same time, he could have turned into a character that he wasn't and written that, you know what I mean? So,
let's say, what happens, since you're the performer of this song, what if Austin performs it?
Then, what do you mean?
Like, do you think that would feel totally different? Do you think it'd feel, I guess, unauthentic? Just because people have heard you play it so much, even though it might be more authentic for him?
I think if he sells it enough, then people will believe it's, like, true as well. Because, especially if people realize that, like, he wrote it with me, you know what I mean? Like, if I make people, because that's, like, you know, the song actually has him singing on the bridge.
Mm-hmm. I was there when you guys recorded that.
Were you really? Yes, you were. Oh, my gosh.
I was.
Wow, that's so crazy.
I'm everywhere.
Yes, you were. You are. But, do you think, you said that people will accept it as less authentic?
Like, do you think if he plays it, people would be like, "Oh, that song that Austin just played was great"? Or do you think they'll be like, "Oh, that was a good cover of Daniel's song"?
I don't know. That's something that we'll have to figure out, you know what I mean? I've never heard him sing the whole song. I've only heard him sing the bridge. And, but that's a really interesting question. I think, let's see. I think it depends on like who's listening to it, you know what I mean? Because people that have heard it over and over again, to be mine, might think, well, that's more true for Daniel, you know what I mean? But if they see like him being like very emotional and just like raw when he sings that, because he is raw when he sings that, like it's just so like powerful when he does sing that bridge, I think people will be like, that is true for him as well. You know what I mean? And, but I don't know, that's a really interesting question. I wish I had like a solid answer for that, but.
Yeah. I guess you won't know until you do it.
Yeah, for sure.